bodies. And as Commissioner was saying again, one of the pillars of the decent work agenda, which is recognized by all the member states of the International Labour Organizations, we recognize social security as one of the pillars. And in this country, that revolves around the pension and protection for occupational injury and disease, as well as health insurance now. So we do have members from NAPSA to deal with the pensions. We do have members from Workers Compensation to deal with work injury. And we do have members from NEMA. Maybe I'll allow them one by one to just come and query if and they agree with us that whether there's compliance or there's no compliance. I'll probably start with the big brother, NAPSA. So NAPSA will be followed by Workers' Compensation, then NEMA in that order.
Although NEMA is beginning to object that they are covered in terms of numbers in yours.
So you can go and talk about it.
I will go straight into answering. I think the aspect of compliance with regard to Zambia Sugar. I think Zambia Sugar is quite compliant with NAPSA, is fully compliant actually, and we share a good relationship with the employer with regard to any queries that come regarding the members or staff and their employees. So they are compliant, I can confirm that.
G4?
G4? G4, I'm not certain because we are not getting any security services from G4.
No, in terms of employees.
Compliance.
Oh, in terms of compliance, yes. We have quite a number of gaps, I think, for G4, but I may not just confirm like to how many gaps we have, but then we have some gaps for some employees.
Please make a follow-up. And let's have the status here.
Thank you.
Honorable Minister, sorry, can we just take advantage of this? We had an issue with time here, and then the
maybe let's finish, then you will comment on all of them rather than one by one. It will take too long.
Sorry.
Just take note of it.
This is Workers' Compensation.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Zambia Sugar is very compliant. And actually, we receive minimal accidents from there. It's rare that we receive accidents from Zambia Sugar. So I think with safety, they're doing very well. With G4S, I'm just asking my colleagues at the office to confirm if they are compliant, but one thing I know is they are registered in Lusaka, so I'll be able to give feedback before we close the meeting. G4S, that's the one I'm saying. I will need to do this. Yes.
Good afternoon. So I'll start with Zambia Sugar. We are missing the proof of payments for February and March. The returns are there, but it's not complete. For a return to be complete, the proof of payment needs to be uploaded. So normally what happens is the payment has been made, but it hasn't been uploaded, so that needs to be done so that the return is complete. So this goes for the union as well. The March return is not complete. Then for the security company, the March return is missing.
So what are you gonna do?
So what happens is they've made the payment, but they've not uploaded the proof of payment. For a return to be complete, the POP needs to be uploaded, otherwise the members of staff will get turned back.
Yes.
Because we can't know who they are paying for. So what they need to do is make sure that they upload the proof of payment, and it just takes 2 minutes.
So you want to tell the PO action one?
So for us, what we'll do is we'll call them in case they're having any challenges with uploading the proof of payment, because they've been uploading them consistently.
So that we are up to date.
Yes.
Well, that they are
yes.
Done.
That they are done and their staff don't get turned
yeah.
back.
Yes, Honorable, just to conclude that so there are penalties attached to sometimes the delays and the non-payment, but good news under the NAPSA, I think the minister did push in amendment to the NAPSA Act where the penalty was previously 20%, it's now 10%. So the minister also is in the process very soon shall issue a statutory instrument to guide the possibilities of waiver where you do qualify. But obviously, one of the criteria that I can already shed light to is the fact that you're consistent and you, with your principle, you are consistent with the principle. So just to urge the members, just to urge Dr. Sugar GS for that, let's be consistent with the principal amount in terms of those payments. So again, I think in the background, the three institutions will get back to you to just see where we are, and the follow-up actions can be taken. Thank you.
Engineer Director.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister, and good afternoon all. In terms of safety and health, I think Zambia Sugar has kept my office very busy. They are quite compliant, very, very compliant. Zambia Sugar being what it is, I think it spans quite wide, and there are various aspects of safety. And they always inform me when things are due for inspections, and I endeavor to bring my inspectors to come through. I'm sure the other colleague indicated that there are very few accidents, if any. They're quite compliant because they do subscribe to management systems that are even higher than what the law provides. That I can attest, they are quite compliant, and I'm happy with the systems that they are running in terms of safety. And we will always be available in terms of working together to ensure that the workers here are kept safe. But of course, where we feel they need to correct, we have also our office in the Southern Province that looks after this area. It's always available to help. And of course, we are very much available. I must say, Honorable Minister, they have been a beacon in terms of even our Vision Zero, they are always present. They're always giving talks. I think they give quite an example to other industries in terms of leading the way in safety and health. I think that is what I can say. With the other institution, is it G4? They are lucky because they fall under the premises of Zambia Sugar. Whatever happens to them will only hold Zambia Sugar responsible because they're coming in here. Okay, so whatever happens to them, we have to make sure that Zambia Sugar takes care of that safety aspect. And I'm sure they are very well aware about it. Thank you.
So you don't have to dig down?
In terms of...
deeper to go to them. So you're saying you give that responsibility, how do you know?
It's under Zambia Sugar responsibility. I won't even look at D4 because I'll look, if anything happens here, I'll go to Zambia Sugar. Yes.
Responsibility.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Derek, come on. Good afternoon, Minister. Again, I'm happy to come back to this room, Minister. I was here last year. We were conducting pre-negotiation training, and we had introduced a concept on productivity-based collective bargaining. I'm happy to inform you that the training was very successful because we actually had a new executive being elected, and they were seated here with management, which is actually a very good practice to have both management, the entire negotiating unit management, and the workers undergoing some orientation. So we had sensitized them on productivity as well as on productivity-based collective bargaining. And I'm also happy just this morning they were confirming that one of the services that we offer they will be accessing next week as psychometric tests. They'll be employing, I think, a number of workers. And we had indicated in our last meeting here that it's one of the best ways of ensuring merit-based selection of our employees. So we should be coming back to undertake those aptitude tests. One of the issues also which came out during the training was the issue of the bonus scheme. The company has a very robust bonus scheme, which has been implemented over the years. And so when we were discussing productivity-based collective bargaining, that's one of the issues that came, which is also quite a very good practice. And of course, there are some concerns that in some cases, there is less understanding of the formulas that are used in the computation of the bonuses, but management was on hand to actually take through the union representatives how that is done. And there was commitment that there will be more further engagements to break down in terms of the computations with bonus scheme. But those are some of the good practices in relation to productivity that we identified. So I'm happy to come back to this room. This is actually a room that we are using for the training. Thank you.
Thank you very much. At this moment, Keith said he wanted to say something. So a response from Zambia Sugar, and on behalf of D42, we would like them to speak on their own. On their, they can also speak. I will conclude and we need you to your productivity.
Thank you, Honorable Minister, and thank you, Labour Commissioner. Indeed, we've noted all the points that you have laid out. Certainly, there are a few gaps. As Zambia Sugar, we do make it a point to comply with the laws of the land. In any areas where there are gaps, we'll investigate those thoroughly and we'll close them. Certainly, they are not as a result of us trying to infringe that regulation, but it's probably just an oversight on the part of officers. But I would like to emphasize that our focus is to always comply with the regulations of the line. Statutory obligations for us is a must, and we always ensure that we are up to date with NAFSA. And Honorable Minister, if I can quickly digress here. There was an issue with NAPS, NPF payments. We had a few employees, well, more than a few, who were being turned away because they didn't have a certificate of service. And so when we engaged the Labor Commissioner's office, he guided and we found a solution to this problem. And to this date, I think we have resolved all those concerns. So thank you very much, Labor Commissioner, on that point as well. Certainly, with all the other statutory obligations, we are compliant. The February and March proof of payment will be remitted to NEMA office by this afternoon. I'm sure it's just an issue of uploading, as the officer stated. We again want to thank you on behalf of Zambia Sugar for visiting us today and for highlighting these pieces of regulation that we need to ensure we comply with. We'll compile all the information that you have requested, Labor Commissioner, and we'll avail them to you in the near future. I'm not sure what the timeline is, but we'll do it at the earliest possible.
Month end.
Thank you very much. I think that's a sufficient timeline for us. And so once again, thank you very much. And to the Ministry of Labor officials, again, thank you most sincerely. As the unions have stated, we have a very good working relationship and we'll continue to do that. Ours is to continue operations for the long haul. Certainly, Honorable, when you came here as a child, you're here today, Zambia Sugar is still running. So we want 50 years from now on, for you to come back and still find them.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Before I hand over to the Honorable Minister, very quickly, sir, you were requesting our office not to grant the redundancies, but Section 55.2 already provides that where an employer intends to terminate a contract of employment by reason of redundancy, the employer shall, it's mandatory, the employer shall be, under paragraph B, afford the employee or the representative of the employees an opportunity to consult on the measure to be undertaken to minimize the termination and the adverse effects of the employer. So you are pushing an open door. So what you are supposed to do is, if they don't follow this, then you lodge a complaint with us. And then we'll charge them on an administrative penalty. That's how it goes. So it's incumbent upon yourself. I submit to the Honorable Minister. So at this point in time, I think we have exhausted what we have to say. I will request the Honorable Minister to give her closing remarks. Honorable Minister.
Thank you very much, Mr. On behalf of the people of Malabo,
this meeting.
Sorry about that.
You forgot the headman.
No, you didn't forget him, but we have...
Thank you.
I recognize the presence of our Honorable Minister for Labor and Social Security, the Labor Commissioner and team, all labor unions represented, government officers present, management from Zambia Sugar, from the party leadership in our midst, and the media. Honorable Minister, on behalf of the district leadership, I wish to take this opportunity once more. Thank you for the gesture to come here to Mazabuga district just a day after we had the Labor Day celebration. So we have found us in the Labor Day celebration mode. I appreciate your coming, Honorable Minister, with your team. You know, Mazabuga district, holistically, is an active district. So many activities happening. As you all know, that our major economic activity in Mazabuga district is agriculture. The biggest entity under that industry is Zambia Sugar. Kalea smallholders, so many farms, and the small commercial trees and farmers. As a result, we have a lot of labor force required in the district. It is right and proper that once in a while, your office comes in the district to find out how we are doing in terms of following the labor laws in the district, which you have done today. There could be some great areas you have noted. Please, it is our wish as a district that advise so that we correct and do what is right in line with Government of Zambia, and the global leadership of his excellence president is up to. And we promise, as you have mentioned, Honorable Minister, at some point, that in our office, you are there. Even as you go together with our labor office, we shall see to it what has been noticed is followed and put right so that we are up to date. Confirmed with the labor laws. The Zambia Sugar, who are hosting us, once more thank you for hosting the labor minister and the team, and indeed all of us. And for all the responses we have given to the questions which you have posed on you, please, where we have not done well, it is right and proper that we put our house in order. Labor issues are being handled by the Minister of Labor. Who is here? If you don't listen to the Labor Minister, who else are you going to listen to? There'll be nobody. I'm not a preacher, but biblically, it is written somewhere that it is read. In the olden days, when people didn't know, they were forgiven. But after they were taught, and they continue to make similar mistakes, they were punished. So the law is very clear. There are repercussions. Once you don't follow certain attributes, there are repercussions. It won't be good for us to be found wanting, even after we have been advised on what is right. This is very short remark. Honorable Minister, I once more thank you for coming. Or maybe by protocol now, before I even sit down, I can impose myself to undertake this responsibility of calling our honorable minister to give her keynote speech. Thank you, honorable minister.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, DC, and thank you very much. Labor Commission and all the directors, our hosts, Zambia Sugar Company. We want repeat what we have already said, but I can't help repeating the commendations that came from the team here that have spoken independently. We said we believe in transparency, and we are here because there's been legacy issues of Minister of Labor does this when they go to industry, meaning staff at Labor does ABCD. So for that reason, we believe in coming as a team like this in some instances, especially when the minister is there, so that we get a picture that is coming from every corner of what we are supposed to do. And I just want to mention that I am a delegate, as he said. If you don't listen to the minister, then who are you going to listen to? I am a delegate of the president. I'm a deployee of the president on behalf of the people of Zambia in this particular sector, in this ministry. For that reason, I adhere and believe in what the new Dawn government believes in. Honest partnership, honest dialogue, partnership, true partnership, I must say, true partnership between employers, workers, and indeed the government. The three of us, in another metaphor that I've heard elsewhere, that there's a prince out there, symbol of the prince, the governor. There's a merchant out there who is the business, basically business industry. And out there, there's a citizen, and which is the people of Zambia. The workers represent that group. But I know the lines are not very, very delineated from each other. We happen to be citizens as well, even when you're in that group and the other group. And that. But in this moment, the three can't do without each other. And of course, the fourth estate, the members of the fourth estate are here. They are the ones who, you know, generate information about what we are doing to govern and take it out and bring the demand and supply, pick it up from those who demand for it and bring it to the suppliers of services, of goods and services. So we are all here in good faith to refine the way we govern ourselves. Good governance, corporate governance is about you. You've been here for a long time. And it's good you didn't say it, but one of us said you are, sometimes you go even over and above, and they talked about it in the very critical area of safety, health and safety. If an enterprise, an entity is able to perform to the levels that you are being described to be delivering to your workers, to everybody here, and then you are at a level where you are able to refine that success in all the other areas that we've talked about here. And to Zambia Sugar Company, I want to mention that this you must take in all the other departments that where you are found to have some room for improvement. When the Labor Commissioner talks about, the law says here you there'll be a penalty and that, it is not meant to hurt anyone. It's not made on emotions of who you like and you don't like. We all know it's about how we govern ourselves. These are the rules that we put in place. So if you're able to do it in safety and health, bonus, social security, that again you're described as one of the best, you're doing a good job in that, well, you are a model, and you can refine that and bring it